SmartSuite continues to push the envelope with the way that they are adopting artificial intelligence. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down for you one of my favorite new features inside of SmartSuite that allows you to create from an AI prompt an entire solution in SmartSuite. That's right, we can now ask AI to create something for us and build the entire solution. The database in SmartSuite is going to come together just with an AI prompt. Sound too good to be true? Well, let's see how it works, testing it live with a timer in this video. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. Of course, SmartSuite is one of our favorite no-code tools, and the fact that they are leaning into AI is really making them even better than before because of the fact that, as I mentioned, we're here to save time. We're here to get organized, and AI is gonna help us do it that much faster. But before we get into the heart of this video, I wanna first invite you to join me for some free training. If you are new to no-code tools in general, you need to understand how no-code automation works because it's going to unlock hours of your time for you. All that stuff that you do repetitively over and over again, no longer do you need to do it manually. Set an automation to do it for you, but first you have to understand how automation works. That's exactly what I'm going to teach you in my free training that you can grab at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. It's all about no-code automation right there, so go ahead and grab that and get instant access to the training. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of the video. We want to talk about AI in SmartSuite. So how can we actually build a solution using AI in SmartSuite? Well, I've just been given access to this beta feature. It is very early testing, so we are gonna pull out a stopwatch right now and actually track how long does it take AI to build this thing, and I'll give you a rough estimate for how long I think it might have taken me to build it if I had to stand it up from scratch. So first and foremost, what you're gonna do is come on into your SmartSuite account just like this. And by the way, if you're not already a SmartSuite user, go ahead and grab our link wherever you found this video and you will get started on a free trial of SmartSuite there. But all I'm gonna do is come on down to creating a new solution. Now, it used to be that I would hit add a new solution and I had two choices. I could either go check out the templates in the library, or I could also just say, hey, I wanna build something from scratch, let's get going. But now you'll see when I click on it, thanks to access to this new feature, I've got a third option here, ask AI to generate. Now, if we hover over here, we're gonna check out a little information bubble is not yet populated. That is how new this feature is. It's still coming out and still being released right now. So not everything is all the way there yet, but I have it on good authority that it works. I'm gonna test it right now for the first time. So I click on here and it takes me right here to a little prompt that says, generate a solution with AI. The SmartSuite AI wizard will create a customized solution in just 1 to 2 minutes based on your needs with the ability to modify it later. And this is the key takeaway, right? We are not stuck in stone with whatever the AI puts together. We of course can bend it, improve it, add to it, whatever we need to do, but it's going to be a starting place for us. A lot of the heavy lifting is gonna be done upfront thanks to the AI. So let's imagine a workflow. Let's imagine that we are a consultant. We are a consulting firm that takes new leads in through a form on our website. These leads then go through our, I don't know what we'll call it, vetting process, where we meet with them, track the status through our pipeline, and ultimately create, or let's say ultimately sign deals with our prospects in this solution. So this is my first time writing in this particular prompt. However, I want to be as thorough as possible. This is something I've learned in interacting with AI in a variety of other tools. It's simply that the more information you give AI, generally the better output you get. So I'm expecting this will be true here as well. So the example that was given to us is a pretty simple one. Build me a CRM for the automotive industry. I want to go a little bit more in detail, but let's just kind of cut it at this and I'll add to this. Please create a CRM solution for me that helps me track this process. I may have overshared here, but I do feel like just my gut reaction here is that oversharing is probably better than undersharing, but we're gonna find out. Now, before I actually hit generate here, I wanna first pull up a little bit of a timer. I wanna hit a stopwatch here so that if this takes 1 to 2 minutes, obviously we don't want to wait the entire time here, so we're gonna just cut to the end result, but I'm gonna get as close as I can to hitting the timer on this as this thing comes into existence. So here we go, start, generate, let's see where we go. All right, there we go. I hit the button to stop that timer as quickly as I could, but once it was done thinking, you see here that it took just over a minute, and this is pretty accurate in terms of time, maybe a few seconds over, but ultimately, this is what we've got. Now, I haven't actually gone in here yet to see, so let's take a look at what it is. Now, first and foremost, we get this message, get your team up to speed fast with the solution guide. Okay, so this is gonna provide an overview of the solution, its use and any other information that will help users jump in. Okay, I wanna learn more. If I click on learn more, it's taking me over here and this is like kind of driving me to the board and the chat. So that's not exactly what I was looking for. What I was wondering is where that actual solution guide is, but I'm just gonna say got it for now. Maybe this is something I have to create myself. There it is. I could type up my own solution. So my initial thought here is that I was a little hopeful that the AI was gonna create a guide for me as well so that I could onboard people more quickly. Looks like that's not the case here, so I would need to actually put this together. However, I can probably still rely on some ChatGPT to put this together for me, so I could always reach out to my other AI tools and put together a solution guide. All right, so moving on from here, let's go ahead and say save, and where's it taking me? I have two different things here, two applications, as we call them in software. I have the leads application, and I have a users application. Now, at one point when I was watching the AI generate the schema here, it did say that it was filling out records for me. So I was expecting to see records here, but this is probably still an effect of this being in beta, that this did not come preloaded with records. Ultimately, that will be a great feature once SmartSuite adds it. I'm sure that they will in time because, as I mentioned, they were already thinking that way. So, what do we have really? I've got leads and users. Let's take a lead and actually fill out some information. Let's say Gareth here. I'm just giving it a title. Put a date created. And I'm noticing that date created is just a regular date field, so we can add that or manipulate that date as needed. We can track the date of last contact. And if and when we close this, presumably we would have the email here, and this is where the name would be. So there we go, it's a first and last name drop down on that particular one when I click in. Size of the deal, let's see what they have. Oh, this is a number field, so it's just asking for a number, so I could say 60K, for example. Phone number, lead source, okay. Now, I'm curious if I have any other views, and I notice here that I don't. It's just giving me the schema itself. So the bare minimum in order to get going with a data schema is to have one grid view per application, which is exactly what I have. It hasn't named these views. It hasn't created superfluous views or anything like that. So it looks like this is the bare bones for me to then modify as I need to beyond here. But still, if I were just sitting down and had mapped this out, creating this application alone, the email, the name, the deal size, the phone number, this would have taken me several minutes to do, right? Probably 5-ish minutes, maybe a little bit longer. Now let's flip on into users and see what's going on here. We have, and I'll just put a user in, maybe these are my team members, so I could say team member number one. And that's exactly what it is, because here's my hire date. So when did we bring this person on? Add their email, fill out their name. We've got phone number, role here. And so we've got some predefined items or options here from our dropdown. I've got a single select field with sales, marketing, management, or other. So that's nice, that's kind of helpful. And then leads. And so this of course is important because leads are connecting to users. So we already can see here that there is a linked relationship built inside of this CRM, our lead management CRM, and I can link records across my application. So this is really helpful, right? This is one of those key things I was checking for to see, is the AI tool smart enough to know that I need to actually build data points and connect them and all of that. And it looks like the early answer to that is yes, indeed it is, which is fantastic news. Looking at views here again, I see that I only have the one grid view, which again suggests that this is waiting for me to kind of build it out all the way. Now, this is part of a three-part series, this particular playlist, where in the next video of this playlist, I am going to be showing you the third way that SmartSuite has opened up new AI capabilities, and that is in particular, right here, I can ask it to do new things for me, create new views, etc. So be sure to stay tuned for that video where we're gonna see how we can create views faster using the AI. So that's gonna be in part three, but for now, I'm pretty happy with the outcome of this. So a couple things here. Number one, if you are new to SmartSuite or if you are new to no code and you wanna give this a try, well, it will be released very soon to the general public. Make sure to grab your SmartSuite account. Number two, what do I think this means for consultants? I'm positive that people are gonna start asking this question. And in fact, I believe that this is actually really good news for consultants in and around the no-code space. Because the big thing here is the user has to have the understanding of what to ask of the AI in order to have this output produced. So I do think that this tool will help people adopt the software more quickly. However, I also think that it's not directly threatening to the consulting space in general, because there's still gonna be a need for experts who know the ins and outs of these products and can actually go deep in this space. Now, of course, I might be biased here because I am a biased party, I am a consultant, but this is, I think, what we continue to see with the release of new tools like this. It helps make things more efficient for everyone. And frankly, consultants are included in that. So maybe this means that we can deliver our services just a little bit faster for our clients and everybody winds up winning. I don't personally think that this is a threat to the consultants and the consulting space in and around no code. I think it's just gonna bring more users and even bigger critical mass in and around the space, which frankly is a good thing for everybody, users, consultants, and everybody in between. So I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you want to make sure to tune in for part three, be sure you've subscribed to the channel where we're gonna be breaking down next week the third output from SmartSuite AI. And in the meantime, keep on building.